What's going on, everyone? So we're back with another After Hours stock market recap. My name is D. Anthony with evolutiontraders.com. If you guys have never came to my channel before, first off, thank you guys for visiting my channel. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on the way out. But let's go ahead and take a look at AMD. There's a lot of charts that I want to go over and kind of break down. So a lot more uncertainty in the market. Obviously, we still know that we're dealing with Russia and Ukraine, geopolitical issues that are going on. So pretty much there's some stocks that were very, very choppy today. There's also a lot of stocks that, you know, pretty much from the word go, they washed out. They tried to make, you know, a very half, you know what, attempt at a little bit of a bounce and then continued washout. That one stock that I'm going to be talking about in this video is going to be AMD. So AMD currently down 7.5% on today's session. We did close down $9.51. We closed at 113.83. So I just want you to keep in mind where we opened up here on AMD. In the pre-market session, we had hit highs of 123.50 and lows of right around this 122.5. Pretty much as we get into the market open, 5 minutes before the market open, we started to lose this 20 SMA. If you guys follow me, you guys know that I'm going to be using the SMA 20 period moving average pretty much as my guide. This is going to be my guide long and short. I am definitely not buying stocks to the long side if we're trading under, and I'm not shorting stocks if we are over. So with that being said, I wish I would have taken part in a longer move on AMD. Normally it's in my wheel well where I'm kind of watching this stock. Did scalp it, did get shaken out of it a little bit, took some profits, not as much as I really wanted to. So you can kind of see here, as we started to flush down, we put this big long wick candle here, started to make a little second attempt bounce here, got rejected at the 200-day moving average, guys. So the two charts, the two indicators, two moving averages that I'm using on my chart is the 200 as well as the 20. These I'm going to live and die by them on the 5-minute time frame when I am scalping. As we came up and we kind of tested this area, we had a continued washout here going to about 7 o'clock in the morning Pacific Standard Time. This is the bounce that I was talking about, where we tried to get a little bit of a bounce, got rejected at the 20, and then pretty much flushed. So your big macro trade, I had had a level here at 120.42 was the level that I was looking at. Only reason that I was looking at that is because I was kind of looking at that first 30 minutes of the day. I was looking at those lows here, and at the time it was 120.42. By the time I was scanning around looking at other stocks, when I came back, we had already tested and made a new low. So I did get into this play late, but 119.88 was going to be the macro flush intraday, just due to the fact that we had this initial washout and then we had this decent bounce back into the 20. And as soon as we rejected this area here, there's two ways that you could have played this. You could have played this on the rejection of the 20 back down through the lows and then kind of see where you stand. You know, if you've got big, you know what, you would have just held through all this price action as long as we stayed under the 20, or you could have waited for that flush through 119.88, which is what I did as soon as we got this red big engulfing elephant bar candle here at around 740 and we washed out these lows. This is exactly when I got short here. Then we decided to chop around for about 30, 35 minutes. And once we started to really push down and take out these new lows, I am always the type of person that's taking profits extremely, extremely quick, especially in this market and especially in these conditions. So as soon as I seen us start to crack below this 118.77 mark and we started to really speed up as we got here, started to lose 118 is when I started to take profits. So I didn't really catch a big move from the point in time when I got in with slippage, being that I was playing options. 1925 was the price, you know, give or take the spread at the exact time. I only took this for about $1 to $1.25. Mind you that every single time I'm playing options scalping, or anytime I'm scalping options, I'm going 90% of the time either at the money or inside the money. Stocks like Tesla, I might go one outside the money. Stocks like Amazon, I might go one outside the money just due to the fact that the premiums are a little bit more expensive. But with something like AMD, I can take 5-10 contracts of this and afford to go one or two strikes in the money. That way, when this move starts to work in my favor, it starts to really work in my favor extremely quickly. As we can see here, as we got this big flush, we came all the way down to this next consolidation point right around this 115. And then towards the end of the day, we still continue to fade, got one more pop up. But what I want to take a look at here on the, you know, just kind of look at the hourly chart, very overextended move to the downside. I could see a little bit of a bounce tomorrow. That bounce would see us taking us into 117. So definitely if we do get some sort of bounce, I would look to take out 115.18. You're going to have a little bit of room to 117. Obviously, any close over 117 is going to be back here, taking us to this prior resistance. This was a washout point here. This was resistance here. It was resistance here. It was resistance here. Finally, when we did break out, we were able to go on a little bit of run. And you can see here when we washed out through this level, it really took us down. So that level that we're looking at, 119.88, is the 20-day moving average on the one-hour time frame. Next resistance I'm looking at is 117 and around that 119, 120 area. Definitely want to keep that in watch. Also, guys, if you like this video, you got something from it, took something away, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Also, see my website at evolutiontraders.com. If you guys are looking for a strategy, you guys want to learn my strategy, you can definitely find it there. Also, if you guys want to trade with me each and every single day live, where I'm kind of going over these levels intraday for you so we can take these trades together, join my Discord. That link is down in the description box below, and I'm going to see you guys all in the next video.